Hey everybody, Jeff Collins here from Idealliance, and today we're doing a little investigation and we're going to see how many of the Pantone spot colors in the Pantone library, solid coated, that we can reproduce using CMYK process ink. So Pantone spot library versus CMYK process, and we'll take a look at offset, digital toner, and inkjet using CMYK inks only to reproduce spot colors accurately under a Delta E of 3. So if you're new to printing and you don't know what Pantone spot colors are, they're specially formulated inks. And if you need more information, please visit Pantone.com. Here is a Pantone swatch book. This is the color bridge where it shows the CMYK equivalent and the spot color side by side so that we can get a decent expectation. And we use this also in print manufacturing as a process control tool. We simply visually or objectively measure these and compare it to the printed product to make sure we have a decent color match. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Actually, before we get started, an example of a box from Kellogg's, it's Eggos. It's using CMYK process to reproduce that waffle there, that image. And then we also have the spot color back here for this pink or magenta color. And then here's a great example of spot colors used for a big brand, Starbucks. This was reproduced using nothing but spot color inks. There's no CMYK process used to produce this package. All right, so let's go ahead and get started and take a look at those different processes of CMYK technologies and determine how close and how many of these Pantone spot colors we can reproduce accurately. Okay, so we're gonna first take a look at a offset press condition using an Icc profile. If you don't know what an Icc profile is, it's essentially a fingerprint of a color printing condition, whether it's CMYK or spot color, or can even be used to capture the fingerprint of a digital camera, so your input profiles. If you need to know more about Icc profiles and what they are, simply go to color.org. Here with the Illuminati logo, so be careful, and you can find out everything you ever wanted to know about the Icc profile format. We're gonna take those Icc profiles, or those fingerprints of that color condition. In this case, we're gonna take a look at offset, and here we have our Pantone solid coated V3 library checked. 1,846 individual spot colors in that library. And we'll go to virtual spot run. So we're gonna select a offset condition. So Grackle 2013, that is a specification that was derived from a sheet fed offset press printing on a number one coated sheet, a premium coated sheet. We'll select that. It's also a gray balanced condition. There we go. Let's get these right. So we're using Delta E 2000 formula to compare the differences between the spot colors and the CMYK condition here. If you're new to printing, Delta E is a measurable difference between one color and another color. So it's used to determine how close two individual colors match to one another. The lower the Delta E, the closer the match. And this formula, Delta E 2000, was designed to calculate differences in color similar to the way that your eye or the human observer perceives color. And here we have all of those spot colors, 1,846, and we are able to reproduce 1,278 of them at 69% of that spot color library without almost no visual difference. Again, it's a threshold or a difference of 3 Delta E 2000, and that's over half of the spot color library. And you can see over here the worst was Pantone 2738, and then of course we have the famous Reflex Blue and the Pantone Violet, and these are not even close to the spot color. Delta E is 16. And then we can sort this and take a look at the ones that are a perfect match, actually. And those are all the spot colors. And there's many of them under a Delta E of 1, almost exact.
Okay, you get the picture. So that is an offset press printing to ISO 12647-2, the ICC profile of this condition is Grackle 2013. So let's try another one. Let's take a look at Inkjet. So simply select that Pantone library, and then we'll select, let's try this KM1, and that's on a Sappy Flow 65 pound matte cover stock, Delta 2000, and we'll set that threshold to 3. And here we can hit 85% of the Pantone spot library with a KM1 inkjet press just using CMYK process inks. Why are we able to hit more? Well, the inkjet world can print a much wider range of colors or more colors using just CMYK process than your traditional offset technology like sheet fed or web. Now let's take a look at digital toner, an indigo. So here we have an HP indigo using orange and violet. So this is actually six color process. This is cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, plus an additional ink of orange and an additional ink of violet to expand that color gamut. That's 83%. So 83% of the Pantone spot color library on this particular condition. That doesn't mean that we can improve press conditions, whether you're on an HP or a Konica or a Canon or inkjet. We can always optimize and expand that color gamut. These are just a few examples from real world production. And then again, 83% of that Pantone spot library. Pretty good. Let's just do one more and then we'll take a look. Here's a Xerox 800 toner press, just straight CMYK. No extended gamut process like that indigo you just saw. And here we have 78% of the Pantone solid coated spot library that fall under a Delta E of 3, the worst being 15. So, and then of course we saw the inkjet press and that really pushed the gamut out just using CMYK inks. And then we saw the HP Indigo using six color process, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, orange and violet. And this goes to show you, you can hit a large variety of the Pantone spot library under a acceptable difference of a Delta E of 3 and below.
Well, that's a wrap for this video, everyone. Thanks for watching. We hope you found it useful and we appreciate your time. Please connect to us at idealliance.org where you can find content like this video, and we hope you have a wonderful and productive day. Take care.